Hi, my name is Charlie Mitchell, and I have no interest in politics. 45 years ago, I lost a grandchild because there was no law against getting an abortion without parental consent. We asked our daughter not to think about abortion because we would take care of her and her baby. But the boyfriend talked her into it, brought her to the clinic so he could pay for it to be done without our knowledge. Then after a few weeks, they broke up. She had deeply regretted this and still suffers from her decision, having a hard time forgetting it. Due to the lack of protection of underage vulnerable girls, she had not been able to conceive because of the damage from that abortion. Because of the lack of safeguards, that abortion not only took her child's chance of life, but damaged her physically and emotionally. Moreover, as we are a close family, the deprived our family of a grandchild and his siblings of a niece and a nephew. That being said, I'm strongly against public funding of the destruction of life by abortion and of deregulating all abortion laws in Rhode Island. This bill would just create countless more victims who will suffer from depression and emotional and physical damage that cannot be undone. Though this happened 45 years ago, it is still a gaping wound on our families. I don't want my money or my children's hard-earned money to pay for abortions like for the likes of abortionists like Hermit Gosnell, who take advantage of vulnerable, uninformed women, who destroy life to be able to do it even up to the time that baby is about to be born. That would be partial birth abortion. Everyone should know about partial birth abortion. That's when the abortionist pulls the baby out teeth first, leaves the head inside the mother, and sticks the knife into the baby's back of the head, in the brain, causing its death. I saw this done on TV. The doctor was performing, showing us how he performed the abortion, and it's just as I described it. And he didn't face him a bit to do it. Partial birth abortion is a misnomer. It is really a murder, causing the death of a child who is ready to be born. This is inhuman and barbaric. Yet you want to allow it and have us pay for it. You want to allow the killing of innocent babies who have done nothing to deserve death, and in such cruel ways, like partial birth abortion, by having their limbs sucked out piece by piece, causing excruciating pain. You want to deregulate all Rhode Island abortion laws? Why? We ask you to support the pro-life bill. If you are not concerned about protecting the lives of women, or little helpless infants, and beside your own, who would you be concerned about protecting? The answer seems to be those who contribute to your election. Re-election. We will all have to answer to a higher power. No exceptions for lawyers, lawmakers, or lawbreakers. God makes it clear that abortion is murder. In Jeremiah 20:17, it says, "For you did not kill me in the womb, with my mother as my own." Jeremiah 1:5 says, "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you." Finally, for everyone, especially people who claim to be Christians, that think that God is not working his children from conception, Psalm 51, "Yet you desired faithfulness, even in the womb, taught me wisdom from that secret place.